When working with wireframe files, you're going to be dealing with basically shapes with stitches inside of them and properties for those stitches. To access object properties, you can do so by selecting an element and then right-clicking it. And that will get you access to any of the properties such as density or underlay or anything that you might be working with as far as how to set up your design outside of the shape. If I look at oneday.ofm, this is one of the files that we tend to use a lot. It's loaded with your software, but if I look at this, I can select at the design level. I got a little bit of a delay here. Select at the design level, right click, and I can go to properties. And that will bring up the properties for anything that everything that I have selected has in common. I know that sounds a little funny, but since I have selected the entire design, I have walk stitches, I have satin stitches, I have complex fills, I have all of these shapes, and they don't have a lot of things in common. Fills and satin stitches have density, but walk stitches don't. So only what they have in common will show up in object properties, at least to start. I can change that by clicking on this drop-down menu and selecting what I want to affect. So if I go down to satin stitches, then I can affect all of the satin stitches in the design. So if I were to change the density, and I'm going to change it to something crazy so that we can see it, but if I were to change the density to like a 20-point density, now all of the satin stitches in the design have a 20-point density. So I can affect large amounts of elements in a design all at one time. Let me hit undo and get that looking a little bit back to normal. You do not need to close the object properties window. If I leave it open, I can actually come select an element and I get just the properties for that element. You will also notice that there are properties on the property bar, but this is a limited view of just the most common properties. It is not extensive. For more information, you can go into the object properties box. Let me close out of this and let me go into another window. A couple of other things that you can do with object properties. Let me duplicate this, and I will change this to embroidery. So you can also double click to get to object properties. I can change this to say embroidery. I'll hit apply. I can make a lot of different changes. Change the typeface, change the size, and when I look at this, I can go back and I can get one element set up just the way that I like it. So I can be working with multiple elements in a design and get one just the way that I like it. I can select that, go to properties, and I can copy the properties from that element and paste it onto the other property, or pardon me, other elements in the design. So with embroidery, I've got just the property that I want, got the typeface, got my density, got whatever. I can then come up here to the copy icon, and I can copy the properties to the clipboard. Then I can come up here and grab this Melco, and I can paste the properties onto that. So I can figure out exactly what I want with just a single element, copy the properties from that, and then paste it across to other elements in the design. Another thing that you could do, you can set up properties for the default, and you can do that either by project or the default for the software. So there are properties that I use all the time. I like to have my tie stitches on. I have my preferred density set up for satin stitches or for fills, and I can save those as the default to my software permanently. To do that, I think the easiest way is to go to a new document, and if this wasn't open, I could go to View and Properties, and then I could choose in this list what I want to affect. Do I want to affect lettering or single line, multi-stitch line angles, multi-stitch line elements. Let's go to all elements, in which case I would go to tie in and tie off, and I would definitely turn those on. I like to have them on. I've addressed my lettering as far as does it have tie stitches or not, and I would remove any manually digitized tie stitches so I can handle everything with object properties. I might choose to have my satin stitches have auto density on just for my satin stitches. Once I get all of these set up, you may choose to have auto underlay on for default. You can save your current settings to the defaults permanently, which means anytime I come into DesignShop, I'm going to be using those defaults, or you can save it to the project. If you have a project that's different than you're normally doing and you want to have those properties set up for this project, let's say I was doing a towel or polar fleece or something like that that's a little bit different than my average design, then I can set that up for the project. If I want to save it permanently, I can save it permanently and use it anytime I want to have DesignShop open. I click on Save Defaults Permanently. I click on OK. And now, whenever I'm creating designs or whenever I'm getting ready to use DesignShop with a new file, I will have my defaults saved permanently. Now, if I open a file that was digitized using either somebody else's DesignShop or my DesignShop before I had saved that, the properties will be saved with that file. So they will not adopt your defaults. They will stay with the file. So you've got object properties that you can set for defaults. You've got them that you can set for the project, or you can change them individually, but you have access to a wide range of density, underlay, any of the object properties that you would need to make your designs look great.